Alrighty then, good afternoon everybody, Silver Dragon here, coming at you with some more Masterwork Dwarf Fortress Madness. Now as always, anyone that has already requested a dwarf has been added to my list. Everyone should be on here so far. And although it may take a while for me to actually get a decent migration wave to get people named, because although there are a couple unnamed dwarves right now, they're all pretty crappy. So I'm not gonna give out just all the crappy dwarves to people. That would be terrible. So I'm gonna wait for a good migration wave of like 20 people and there are 20 dwarves or something. Hopefully I do get something like that, and I'll just keep getting 3, 3, 4, 3, something like that. That would suck. And once I get a good deep migration wave, I will actually name everyone off stream, that way, or well, off recording, that way I can actually not waste time, because, you know, that usually takes like 30 minutes just to name everybody. But anyway, I will take care of that as I can and just show off, you know, who got named. Now, as always as well, if anyone has any questions about Masterwork Dwarf Fortress, you know, or any game in general, feel free to send them to me and I'll answer them as I can. Now, of course, last time we managed to get a lot of this stuff dug out. Let me actually click on this thing here. Okay. Of course, we have a farming area, which is progressing quite well. Our temporary food and storage and stockpiling area, which will be removed once the kitchen area is dug out. Our hospital is set up for the most part now. We actually do have some traction benches going into there. Our danger room is on the way. And we should probably get some actual spare beds ready for the military barracks here as well. Unfortunately, I do not have any spare beds at the moment. Alright. Oops, our crafting area is on the way to being interesting. Let me check on this one. Yeah, we're making some wooden training spears. I'll make a couple of, toss a couple of beds in there while I'm at it. We are working on making our ore, which turned out to be a combination towards making bronze. So we will be making bronze armor here in the near future. And we'll probably have to move this guy too eventually. Pardon me, eventually. Then we have our, well, general stockpile area, which is slowly filling up quite a bit here. Actually, I should probably increase the bars and blocks stockpile somehow. Anywho, we then, of course, have the great dining hall, which has been pretty much entirely dug out now, so it's just ready for some tables and chairs. And most of the living quarters have been dug out as well. So once they're done a lot of that, they'll work on the... oops. Let me continue that. They'll work on the kitchen. Actually, no, it looks like they're going to work on the kitchen first, and then they're going to work on that. What the hell? Oh, okay, he's messaging me. Look over the documents. Yeah, no, that's fine. We already know exactly what the documents foretell, so it's alright. Discuss what we're willing to offer you for your craft dwarf ship. Okay, this is important to know. Suppose I'll mine both of these, that way I know exactly where I'm going to be putting it. Okay. The export agreement. So they really want illuminations, they want hourglasses. Now illuminations, I can make them easily. Drinks, handware, that's not going to happen. And then the last three, silk dice, quivers, and headwear. I suppose I could make some bronze headwear, that would be good for them, but illuminations do seem to have a really good price. And it would also depend on the quality and the material made up of that it's made up of, so... Yes, may our fortunes rise and fall together next year and all that good stuff. And just found some more materials here. Ooh, cave fungus, how lovely. Now I can make some delicious cave fungus cheese. Alright. Let's go check on the rest of them here. Now, another thing that I do want to do that I should actually start making, like, pretty damn close, or pretty damn soon, is, I need to, let me segment this here and get them out of here. Okay, as far wide as I can get this thing, because those boars are bloody massive breeders, as you can see there. We're moving all of our Cragtooth boars over to a new pen so I can get them out of my way. Oh, what the hell? No, not the Mastiffs. Mastiffs can stay where they're at. I will also put the Tuskox bulls in there. Oh, we actually do have some Mastiff puppies. Lovely. Nowhere near as many as the Cragtooth Boar Piglets, though. Jeez. I am going to start having to do some selective slaughtering here soon, because we just have way too many. God dang. Look at all this. Ah, we actually do have an animated iron spear. Ooh. Someone must have brought an animated iron spear with them. That's pretty nice. Alright, so I'll move all the animals over to that, and I can start building. Looks like until they're moved, they're all moving back towards the caravan. So all my lazy dwarves are starting hauling them around. With that done, I can just remove these entirely. So let's do that. Okay. Now I need to start working on the central structure here. So build, capital C, and then wall. Oops, too much. There we go, that should do it. Make it out of trade license, yeah, no. Shield blocks. Wall. There we go. And perfect. Wow, I took all my shield blocks, but I made it. Huh. And I'll probably move the Ward of Armok to the front of it. Actually, I don't even need this one here, because I'm just going to put a... I'll put a bridge here, actually. To seal it entirely. It's going to raise that way. That's what I'll just have to straight up make from shale, because I don't have enough blocks. But that's perfectly fine. So this will be our inner, like, sealed-off courtyard here. Beside it, we'll have our trade courtyard. Once these guys leave, I'll probably move the trade depot back towards me a little bit more. And then I'll begin designing the other one. Okay, let's go to my... right here. Just make keep making blocks. This one will just keep making ivory crafts. Alright. And that should be good. And of course, this top area here will be sealed off as a as our animal area. Uh-oh. God damn, it had to be a possession. Couldn't have been a fey mood. And it's my bone carver, too, so obviously he's going to want bone. Alright, let's see what he's yammering about, if he is yet. Oh, he's yammering, alright. Needs bones, yes, obviously. That's it. Just needs bones. Alright, let me go to animals. Animals. Now... dear lord, we have way too many. Okay, so I'll designate a lot of the female Cragtooth piglets for slaughtering. Because if they mature, we're going to have way too many piglets. Alright, resume. I wish I actually had a, you know, I should probably build one just in case. Build workshop if I can even. It'll be outside, and it won't be that amazing, but... let me remove... two sections of wall, because this requires blocks. And I'll replace it with regular shale. Okay, workshop... whoops. Alright, what do we got here? Shrine of Armok. There we go. Alright, so we'll have our basic Shrine of Armok made. I will give our priest, if I can find him, architecture. Because we do have one guy who has faith. Or praying. Or at the very least, he's an apostle cast. Damn it, you're in my way. Jewelers, dwarven apostle, this guy. Architecture. Okay. Confirm change. So that way he can get things done for that. They're leaving on their journey. As a matter of fact, you know what? Let me see here. Who do I have on my misc? Let me add. I will name this one off here just so I know who he is. Sit nickname. Kurtzman, the what the hell? Don't know how I screwed that up, but anyway, Kurtzman, the apostle of Armok. Will be my only priest right now. So hopefully he'll go up there and build all that. Actually, who do we have doing butchering? Should probably double check that. Looks like Gears is doing butchering. I'll create more than one. Because he's going to be... You know what, because he also has to have souls for this, I'm also going to give him butchering. Pray for booze. Start rain, pray for rain. Oh, so we can actually pray for rain and then start the rain. Well, once we start sacrificing some souls here, I'll have him pray for... Actually, I don't think we can we? Leprechauns. Fucking leprechauns. What? Get up top, man. Get up top. We got some leprechauns to murder. Leprechaun is fighting the Mastiff. Oh, nice! Stray Mastiff bites him in the left shin, tearing the muscle, latches on firmly, Leprechaun falls over as the Mastiff starts shaking him around by his left shin, tearing apart the muscle, bruising the bone, artery in the left shin has been opened by the attack, many nerves have been severed, ligaments have been torn, and tendon has been torn, so he just decimated his entire left shin area. Leprechaun then had tried to attack him, but he the Mastiff, but he dodged. Bit him in the torso, tearing at the muscle, bruising the gut, latched on firmly, and then just shook him around till he just burst in half, basically. Just split him straight in half. Good job, boy. Good job. Alright, squad, attack, or squad A kill, and then R for the leprechaun. Well, R for the area where the leprechaun's at. Let's go kill, because there's one above you as well. Kill leprechauns. There we go, let's see that one here. Swords Dwarf, Mr. Korvik is fighting. Attacks, but leaps away. Counter strikes, but he misses. That just goes on for a while. Finally collides with him and knocks the leprechaun over. He then runs the leprechaun through the left shin. Again, they like to go for the shins with these leprechauns. I don't necessarily know why. But apparently it's quite effective, tearing apart the muscle, motor nerve has been severed, lodged his sword in the wound, but he managed to twist it around his left shin, doing further damage. He dodged and hit the leprechaun in the left shin, again, another shin. Actually, the same shin with the right hand. Oh, so he just punched it this time. Slashes leprechaun in the lower front teeth. With his blade, with the blade of his sword, and the severed part sails off in the dark. So he just, somehow managed to swing his sword just through the thing's mouth and just knock out most of its teeth. With his sword. That's pretty badass and also horrifying, if you think about it. And then he finally ran him through the torso with the tip of his sword, and apparently that was enough to sever off his entire torso. The sheer power of the dwarf of the dwarves has come through here, as he can sever an enemy's torso simply by piercing him straight through with his sword. There we go. He finally began his mysterious construction. That's good. All right. Now let me go down here for a second. Damn it. I need a door. And let me construct a couple more spears. So I'm sure I'll need them. Alright, he's making the blocks. That's good. Let me go up top here and actually continue constructing these. So build, capital T for trap, and then capital S for upright spears. And we will select 5. Done. Capital S. 5. Done. And then we'll head down. Here we go. I believe if I go capital N. Yep, this is the danger room. So activate link to spear, capital S, upright traps. Ooh, we need more. We need a lot more. Now, I could go in and just tell them into the manager and just tell them to build, like, you know, a couple dozen of them, but... Now, I'm noticing they're not processing this properly. So, we need to figure out why that is so. So, to the manual! Quickly! Furnaces... Let's see, the ore processor runs on the mason, carpenter, or mechanic, I think that's just to build it. Yeah, machine operating skill. So I need to figure out who are my smelters and why, if they have the machine operating skill, which they don't. That would be why they're not actually getting it done. All right. So that's why we have no metal influx right now. It's because I forgot to actually attach that. And you could actually, if you take a look at the manual there, it has everything you need, really. An interesting one is the brick oven here, which I'm now seeing, and I just accidentally lowered it here. The brick oven actually allows you, as you can see there, to... designate off certain materials, available colors, so you can basically, make mass coloring to various bricks and, place them wherever you want. So you could create a bunch of green bricks and place them in a nice design or so on and so forth. So you could turn your dining hall into one just really, really cool piece of art if you so desired. Of course, I'm not sure if I'll do that, but I might. I might down the road if I have, if it turns out to be like a 12-year fort and it's, all kinds of easy, then who knows, I might just do that. So we'll pray for hard metals. And just constantly pray for hard metals. Okay. Let's see if there's anything inside this with T. Just the building material. So I'll destroy that. I'll have somebody come disassemble that. He created a crag tooth boar bone right mitten. Really? Just get back to work, you fool. Get back to work. Make ivory tooth crafts. Clearly, I need some people with masonry here. Clearly. I really need a new migration wave. Hmm. You're a furnace operator, but I'll also give you masonry right now. Just because I need somebody to have masonry and get all this stuff built. Otherwise, we'll have no defenses. Okay. We have a lot of idlers right now. Oh, hell, I forgot to check on my miners to see how well they did. Oh, wow, they've cleared everything out. Ha! Ah! Wow. In that case, let me give my idlers something to do here. No, not I need P for stockpile. F for food stockpile. I only need two of them. Alright, Q. Settings. Alright. Everything except for... Oops. Drinks. There we go. Let's click on the wrong damn one. Everything except for drinks, and I'll say extract. And this guy... Everything except for drinks. Alright. Now build. Workshop. Let's get a kitchen in here. Out of shale. And we'll get L, brewery or distillery, up in this corner out of shale. Mine that bit if they don't mind. Okay. I suppose I can get these guys working on my aquifer now so that they can have quick access to the water source at some point here in the future. So, I created that. So where did I put the... Ah, here we go. So I'll let them start digging on my aquifer then. And all the little bits and pieces to go with it. I'll leave this section for now. Just because that entails... additional things that'll have to get done later. What are you doing, wussies? Get over here. Arg, must be some water like right above. Oh, it's lengthwise too. That sucks. As this takes a minute for me to actually get it done. There we go. Finally. Now what was this here? Something happened? Ah, it's grown to become a ram. I see. Alright, I need somebody specifically designated to just masonry right now. Because no one else is getting the dang job done. And we need somebody up here to get that stuff done. Let me actually go and disable the blocks construction as well, just to make sure that they aren't being distracted by that. Oh my god, are you serious? Another one? Bloody hell. At least it's a shorter one this time around. So it should be easier to get rid of. Alright, let me go down here, build door. I'm going to restrict pets from entering this door. Trap, spike trap. You know what? Close enough. Close enough. What is our mechanic doing? Gears. Toggle all of his hauling off, just in case. Tool making and tanning is fine for you. That will disable your butchery for now. Alright, so hopefully he'll get down here and start working on that. There you go. Come on, buddy. You can do it. Pierce on through that. Alright, done. Now they just have to actually continue the bloody thing this time around. Perfect. Needs logs. Are we out of logs? That surprises me slightly, but let's dig up some more then, shall we? Then I'll have you dig up the logs on the front here as well. Resume. Alright, let me make sure he actually still has access to that, because I might have turned off his... I did turn off his lumbering, so he wouldn't get distracted. Alright. So, finally he did come up here and build this a little bit. I think this was also completely constructed, so I just had to hook it up. Alright, it's time I designate out my burrow. My home burrow. Name. So this is the emergency burrow we go to in as the absolute, you know, oh god, we're under attack, you gotta hide, kind of thing. There we go. Make things easier in that regard. And let's encompass this whole thing. We'll need our hospital, obviously, available to us. Ah, bloody hell, getting hungry, apparently. Everything that we need to be accessible to our dwarves while they're inside here needs to be selected. Alright, then this whole structure. Bam. Down. Get inside there. Then probably all this as well. Well, I'll leave that as that for now, because we will still have more to designate down here. A little mini fortress to build and all kinds of stuff like that, so... But all I really need is once they're inside, I can close the gate and just set them free to do anything they want. That way they're not restricted by what they have around them. I don't think his prayers have been answered yet. Then again, he is just leveling his prayer capabilities, so we'll see how that turns out. I really, really need a good migration wave right now. Oh, we need more malachite, so we're running out of materials. So I should probably get down here and have them start digging up more. Yeah. Oh, excuse me. I don't really want to dig this up, but I guess I have to. For the sake of all the lovely things that I need to mine here, it must be done. There we go. Although, try at least only mining out the vein, that way I can fill it up again later. There we go. That's what happens. It sucks that it has to be on the level that I'm designing this, because it, you know, it starts to make things look a little bit ugly. But, you know, I can't turn down this ore when I need it. There we go, perfect. Have them dig this bit up. Oh, we even got some cave fungus there now, too. Maybe I'll just block it off and have it be like the secret cave behind our dining hall. Oh wow. Quite a bit back here. Let's dig out some more cave fungus. Now I'll have my kitchen start working on some cave fungus cheese. Render fat to tallow. Make us some easy meals if you don't mind, good sir. Maybe grind up some mead, or mead. Yes, grind up some mead. It'd be amazing. But no, grind up some meat and we'll be able to make some sausages. Let's see, he became an Apostle of Armok. Lovely. Some nice rich malachite vein here, I tell you that much. So at this point, just mine the whole damn thing out. There you go, boys. Oh, hey, more cave fungus. This will be definitely an interesting, intricate, like, little mini cave we have hidden behind all of our stuff here. There we go. Again, more cave fungus. That shall make some delicious cheese, apparently. Because cave fungus is good for that, I guess. Who knew? Personally, I don't know if I would enjoy cave fungus cheese. It just doesn't sound like it would sit well, does it? Alright, now that I'm done this bit here, let me go and make sure that he's actually going to make use of it. Add new task. Alright, let's go to the smelter. Oops, that's this guy right here. And we're going to smelt pure tin, pure copper ore. Make 3 coke from wood. Oh, that would actually be convenient. We already have plenty, so I don't really need a lot. Oh good, they finished it up finally. Perfect. Now I need them to build the trade depot once again. Alright, build the trade depot. We can also start building the expensive depot, which is... Where is that actually? Build workshops. I think it's down here. Yeah, there it is. Now we have... When you can... Blah, 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 blah. Someone actually had asked me about this earlier, about the, you know, how the old economy was turned off, where we used to have to make, you know, coins for trading and stuff like that, because it was broken for some reason, in some way. And, Masterwork does actually use coins now as well. Basically, you have, Morrill's Tavern here, which I will also build. Morrill's Tavern can be used to, basically... you play music there, which can give your dwarves various bonuses. Of course, I need a musical instrument to build the tavern. And it also allows the exchange of coins. So you can trade copper coins for silver coins for gold coins, and gold coins you trade at any of these workshops, or any of these trading stalls, basically, market stalls, in order to acquire rare or not-so-rare items. Such as not-so-rare, the bargains, Bomrex bargains. But I want, let's see, Steel Emporium, Pet Shop. I want Tedek's Fine Goods, if I'm not mistaken, is the one I want. Yes, Tedek's Fine Goods should be the rare items that you can't quite acquire otherwise, such as, let me build this here. And a trade license. Such as Glomprong, or was it Featherwood, if I'm not mistaken. Okay. Let's see, I should be right. Is this good enough? No, widen this even more. There we go. Alright, I'll need shield for that. Perfect. Where is that place though? Ah, I just need to go one more forward. That should do well. There we go, perfect. Actually, is that going to be wide enough to allow caravans in? It should. Let me remove this bit right here. There we go. Guess it'd be a little uneven, I suppose. Don't have much choice. Alright, shale. Shale. As you can see, this is something that's going to take them quite a while to build, depending. There we go. Right here we'll have our area that takes us to the pen. Man, I hope this is not a copywritten song. Because it is a song I've heard many a time. There we go. Yeah, I'm probably gonna get hit on this. Oh well. Needs unrotten milk. There we go. So my bone carver is going to make some bone crafts and just general ivory crafts as well. He also give you bone crafts. Decorate with bone, I guess. We'll also raise that up. Could raise the value of our other items with that. Alright. This will give the idlers something to do. Remove both of those. Alright. We'll have to set these guys up somewhere else better soon. Oh hell. And let me give them another seed stockpile, because right now they seem to be lacking in the seed storage area, as it were. Let me remove that. Food. Settings. And forbid everything except for seeds. Alright. Wow, they've actually completely filled up the whole thing. Damn. We're going to need something that I cannot locate right now. There it is. We're going to need a bunch of barrels in order to store stuff and a bunch of bins. So hopefully we can get that done soon. Hopefully he also has gathered us enough spears, capital T, capital S, that I can finish this thing up here. Close enough. Alright, go downstairs to the dining hall, F5, and apply. Darn it. Close, so close. Just need one more. You can do it, mechanic. I believe in you. I believe. Alright, now what else can we get done here? That's important. We definitely need to start getting more tables and chairs and getting the dining hall set up. Actually, who do I have that's an engraver? Did I actually give anyone engraving is the question. I did. Giuseppe. Alright, my friend, it is time. It is time for you to begin your mighty work. Eventually I'll have to find a miner, or a new miner, that is, to replace you. But it's time to smooth out some stone, my friend. There we go. Smooth. All that insanity out. Alright. I'll also have you smooth out all of this. And that should help us get pretty darn close to legendary. Probably not completely, but, you know, he'll be doing quite well. Oh, F. F me. Beakwolves. Uh-oh. We're in trouble. We're in trouble. We're in trouble. We're in trouble. There's only one thing I can do at this point. Crap, crap, crap. I have to risk everything. Damn it. Go to citizens. I'm sorry, Mr. Corvus. I'm sorry. I didn't have time, man. I didn't have time to set you up properly. Work animals. Signing all mastiffs. Let's see. Oh, do you still have the animal training capabilities? You do. Okay, good. Alright, let me remove the zone here. Animal training. Go to animals. Animals. Quickly. Quickly, my friend. War train, war train, war train, war train. Hopefully it'll take a while for them to get set up. And let me put the blade in their trap. It should slow them down. We'll put the animated iron spear in their way. I really hope somebody gets that soon. Let me go... shit. Noble screen. Oh, there's no point. It's not... I don't have enough time! I don't have enough time! Oh, what a bad timing to get a freaking wave of enemies like this. Oh, this could kill me. Nobles. Someone useless. No uniform. I honestly don't think they're gonna stand a chance there. Oh shit. Oh no, he's going out alone. Why are you going out alone, Korvac? Yeah, this could end us easily. Easily. This is the Bleak Wolves invasion is actually part of the... What's it called? Additional invaders thing that I enabled to make things interesting. I just didn't expect them to attack so soon. Alright, let's do this. No, they're retreating. Back off. Everyone back off. We killed enough of their kind, it seems. Thank you! Oh my god, I love these frickin' animals so much! Oh my god, do I love these animals. They're amazing. That's right, you get the F off my land, boys. Who died? Craigtooth Boar, Mastiff, I know one of our workers died. I did actually send him in there by alone to attack the thing, so I'm not in the least bit, surprised that he died. But still, our Cragtooths have prevailed. They are awesome, awesome frickin' animals, and I am greatly enthused, as it were. I am greatly happy of them. Sell oil, sell silk thread for 1,000 shillings, 1,500 shillings, and a shilling is a silver coin. And then I would need sovereigns for Glomperong Log. So I need 1,500 pretty much sovereigns for gold coins for a Glomperong log. Blah, 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 blah. Oh my god, I'm so surprised we survived that! I know they were on the easy side of things, but my god, how did we survive that? Oh, it looks like Mr. Corvus is wounded. Herr Doctor. Oh man, all the animals did their jobs. I am very, very, very happy with them. We have done well. We have done very, very well. Okay. Distillery, brew, drink from whatever you can, my friend. Everyone else just get to... Oh, God, I completely forgot to check up on their progress here. Oh, they completely dug it out. Okay, good. Build door. Let's get our door in here. I need to get them to build the... Add... Where is it? Build wooden floodgate. Promote that up to the top. Alright. God, I desperately need that migration wave. There we go. Okay. Link to... Damn it! Not enough mechanisms. My mechanist is being lazy. Come on, Gears, you can do this. I believe in you, man. It is now winter. Also, damn you, lag. And there we go.
I can't do it.
The wet season has finally arrived. Thank you. Let's see. No. Actually, yes, we'll need a coffin. I will need a coffin. I also need a cabinet and coffer. For some reason, sound sense is confused and playing two different sounds at once. That's weird. Alright. Hopefully one day a mason will be come over here and we'll get that done. My god, I'm definitely going to have to control the cragtooth boar population, but they're doing an amazing job here, I have to say. Man, that animated spear did a great job, though. Okay, so that leaves me with... Okay, good. So I'll have the path straight around the center of it. And then I'll see what else I can do with that. Because I'm going to have little nooks in the center here, where they'll be able to deploy their weapons. My god, we desperately need a migration wave right now. It's killing us not having a migration wave.
Ugh, I won't do it.
Now the other music takes centerfold, so that was weird. Having both of them play at once. Then milk 'em, you fool. There we go. So yeah, eventually I'll have some guys full-time, you know, shearing these things. Full-time, getting just getting generally stuff done. Pray for hard metal. We can't really trade you much right now, sadly. Alright, good enough. Oh man, there's like nothing I can really do right now other than just wait. Because a lot of my guys aren't getting what I want them to get done. Finished. Build. Let's see, my floodgate was made. It was, so I'll get that in place. Wooden floodgate. Alright, that'll be what, well... Except we have a couple of levers, actually. Okay. Keep tightly closed. Alright. Now here is the moment of truth, everybody. Station at Danger Room. Here's the moment of truth. Hopefully he does not get killed because of this. And also hopefully the animals don't follow him in. Although it will erase their capabilities. If they keep healing up the animals, who knows, they could become legendary dodgers. Actually, that might be an idea. That might be an idea. Maybe I could make another smaller Danger Room that has only like one spike per tile. And leave that for the animals. That way I can level the animals and I can also level up, you know, animal healing. Animal caretaking. Where are you?
Sir, there's some more dwarves that are
around. Oh, finally. Oh, he's not doing his job though, so I'll just move him here myself.
I love cats. Delicious.
Delicious. Alright, there we go. Someone pull on this lever constantly. Please and thank you. Okay, let's see how he does. Now let's also see what we picked up here for migrants. I hope we have some good freaking migrants for once. Oh, finally a migration wave of 11 migrants. We have an alchemist, it looks like. Two of them are actually good at alchemy. Let's see if we have any dwarf. Ah, a healer. A healer with no healing skills. Oh, it's because you're a child, aren't you? Yep, 2 years old. I love how children are freaking in healing the healer cast. Or in a cast period. So basically, we have a whole lot of nothing here. So we have a whole lot of not really that great kind of dwarves that I can just kind of toss wherever I want. They would make good military dwarves, it looks like, but I don't need military dwarves quite right now, and I don't have the capability of setting up military dwarves. So more than likely off stream, I'm going to see about designating a lot of these guys specific jobs and, you know, getting them named for people that wish to have them named. Let's see, he's miserable right now. It's working! It's working! He's not getting wounded from it. Let's check his general stats. He's already a great swords dwarf, a legendary fighter. He's been in here a whole 2 seconds. See, as long as they have the correct armor protection for it, they just get golden and they come legendary in no time at all. Oh yes, I almost forgot. Assign you your own personal room, good sir. Build. Let me build. God, was it coffers H? I think an F for cabinet. Okay, they haven't built them yet. They just haven't constructed them all yet. So by keeping the door tightly closed, I'm keeping all the animals out of here from injury while he gets trained. Is already legendary plus 5 fighter. We'll take a look specifically here in a second. So we'll read dwarves, go to military. Yeah, he's already a level 20 swords dwarf, a level 20 fighter. And shield user and all that will be increased, well, a little bit every now and then. Takes a lot of it, a lot to increase those ones though. So he is now a sword lord. Mr. Corvus C. Shack opened, swords lord. Here, let's stop that for now. Okay, you can go do what you want now, my friend. Check out your new crib if you want. Let's get your cabinet and container whenever they make the damn thing. Ah, oh, I swear, the laziness of these dwarves, the laziness. It's ridiculous at times. Alright. But oh yes, the one thing I will do though, quickly, labors, I will globally enable masonry so they can finish up the damn walls. At the very least, that's the first thing they're all going to be doing. Hey, we got our first bit of bronze, I think. Bronze bars. Ah, no, it's from praying. From praying, we've got one bronze and one iron bar. I see. It looks like my time is almost up here, so let me go check on this here quickly. Smelting. So we've been smelting these two, if they've actually been doing it. Make bronze from copper, from 2 tin and copper. There we go. And make sure we have furnace enough for people furnace operating. I will re-enable your furnace operating, good sir. Disable that. And I'll give you oven operating as well. Just so that we can keep this going here.
Sorry, sir, I can't do it.
You better, or else. Alright, let's do this thing. Yep. Go back to him, re-enable his woodcutting, because again, he's the only one woodcutting, and that's actually something I will fix next time as well. I'm going to have more than one guy woodcutting, you know, no job will be alone this time. I'll get the fishers done, we'll get more people working on kitchens, you know, we'll have specific guys designated out to specific jobs, but there won't be just one guy working on a single thing anymore. I will try and make sure that we have at least two people per job. What'd he grow unattached to? Oh, no problem. He grew attached to his scale plate cloak.
Sir, I hate saying no to you, but no.
You know what? It sucks, but I'm gonna have to give it to him. Let me go military equipment. Let's go G gloves, specific gloves. There we go. So I'm actually giving him the bone gloves, giving Corvus the bone gloves, because right now he's miserable. All the animals he had with him, or several of them, got slaughtered, and that's really, really hurting him. He is the only guy right now. He is really, really close to being, you know, pretty much flipping out and going insane, and I can't allow that. He is my legendary dwarf. I need him desperately. So I am, even though the artifact is a crappy bone gauntlet that won't really defend against much, I'm giving it to him to make him incredibly happy. Where is he now? Captain Ahab! Okay, he's storing an item in a stockpile. Okay, once he's done that, maybe he'll go pick up his new equipment. At least I hope he will. Okay, man, so we got our main migration wave here. I also need to designate a, which I completely forgot about. We're gonna need a crypt, which I guess I'll put down here. And I'll design this one nice, like, really nice, like I did last time. Okay, let's go like this. This is my Hall of Heroes. And actually, instead of a door, I'm going to have a statue in front of each of these. So let's see here. Okay, so 6. So each one of these will be capable of holding 12 dwarves. And then they'll have it sectioned off to each side. But yeah, that's what it'll be. Each section will hold 12 dwarves. Oh shit, I forgot to check and make sure that nobody was stuck behind the floodgate here, getting starving to death. Okay, good. Link to floodgate. Alright. Notes, capital N. Place note. Oh, let's see. I'll just put aquifer. Because why not? That works. Alright, so he still has to go link those up to the floodgate. Let's see what else we need to do. We need to start mass producing items. I need to designate all the guys off. Our number one priority right now is to get all of this sectioned off properly, to get all of my walls up. This whole area up here will be walled off completely in order to accommodate all of my animals. So these guys are going to have to go batshit crazy on masonry. Actually, I'm gonna design this bit right now, even if I can. No, I have to clear away all these damn trees, I guess. Well, some of it I can do. Some of it looks like I can do. All right. Oh my god, excuse me. So we'll have this area sectioned off for the animals so that they can relax, and we can have big, you know, stockpiles and workshops and all kinds of stuff here for our workers so they can do their thing. Alright, nope, too much. That'll do. Okay. So all of this is going to have to be completed next time. So I'll keep all of the current workers. I'll designate off their new skills. But I'm going to keep them generally doing what they're doing for the next bit. Just because I'll absolutely need all of this to be finished. There we go. Then our refuse stockpile will be larger and have a much more dedicated area to it. And that's all that I'm designing right now. So next time around, they're going to have to be number one priority to finish up these walls here. Get the gates in place, I should say. Blah, 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 blah. Actually, let me put... There we go. And that's going to raise up there. Alright, so yeah, that's it for now. Thank you for watching, guys. Hopefully you all enjoyed. I will section off and name everyone that I can before next episode. If you have already claimed a dwarf, it's on my list. I have it all ready to go. If you have yet to claim a dwarf, definitely do comment, and I will see about getting you a dwarf. But yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Have yourselves a great afternoon, evening, whatever it happens to be, and I'll catch you all next time for some more Masterwork Dwarf Fortress. Silver Dragon out.